Well, tonight is the final of the BBC Two Floodlit Trophy, a very important trophy these days, and a very important final tonight because Hull Kingston Rovers have never won the trophy. St. Helens have won it twice, and the man guiding St. Helens tonight is a very famous coach, a famous man, famous player, Eric Ashton. Eric, how do you read Hull Kingston Rovers tonight?
Well, I've had the privilege, Eddie, of watching them on two occasions this season, and on both occasions, they've impressed me very much. Particularly the game at Castleford, where I thought possibly it was the best OKR side I've seen in my time in rugby league. And we're in for a very hard game tonight, there's no doubt about that.
Well, both Eric Ashton and Roger Millward have been summarisers with me during the Floodlit series. Eric, what about Roger Millward?
Oh, well, he's a great player, isn't he? I mean, there's nobody can take that from Roger, and he's doing a great job as a coach at the moment. I think it is an advantage anyway to be a player coach, particularly if you're a player of Roger's calibre and he can get the players to do as he wishes on the field. I mean, I am sat on the touchline, and when I say before, the game has to go.
With a lead of 13 points to 7. And a try in by Millward.
Well, last week, Roger Millward did summaries for St. Helens and Salford. What did you find out about St. Helens?
I found that they're very professional side, very compact, very tight, and they didn't give much away. What Salford got, they had to work for and work very hard.
Any particular man or men that you're going to tell your lads to watch out for tonight?
Well, Harry Pinner had a good game last week. Bill Francis, obviously, he's always in the thick of things. So these are two of the people that we will be keeping a special eye on tonight.
A home tie, a very big advantage, you reckon?
I think so, especially in front of this crowd we've got here.
They're very vociferous, aren't they?
Yes,
they're already warming up.
Yeah, they're a wonderful crowd, and they get behind us and give us all that we need.
Final tip for the score?
I don't know about the score, Eddie. I think it'll be close, but I'm hoping that it comes out on OKR's side.
And your great respect, of course, for Eric Ashton as a coach.
Great respect as Eric as a coach.
And I won't make the obvious with three fellas trying to tackle the hope. A good pass and well taken by Cunningham. Fine night. Pretty dry ground. Clean football so far. Peter Quinn, a member of McGuigan. Pimlet on his own, but he slings a long one to Jones, and Jones, does he dive in to get it? He does.
So, highlights of two matches there that bring St. Helens and Hull Kingston Rovers to this final tonight. Not a lot of luck for St. Helens, I might add, but the half-time score, Hull Kingston Rovers 11, St. Helens 3, and Pimlet had to leave the field very early on, and Jones just before half-time. But we'll talk about the team in a minute. Let's talk about the first try was scored with Rovers on the left. It was scored by Mike Smith, his first of the season, off Millward, veer low, and that was the first try to make it Hull Kingston Rovers 3, St. Helens 0. And then Pimlet went off, he was injured, and he limped about, and this big crowd saw Peter Glynn go to fullback. But again, an attacking thing, moved by St. Helens, Peter Glynn, he got a solo try. It was a 25-yard effort, and that brought it 3-3. And so St. Helens was smiling again. But in the 15th minute, with the crowd, and a very big crowd tonight, roaring on their feet, Clive Sullivan, supporting Lancasey, don't forget in blue, dark shirts, Hull Kingston, to Clive Sullivan, making it 6-3. And there was quite an appeal going on about this, but the try was given. And followed by that, we had a full row stride, making 9-3, then 11-3. And St. Helens coming out without Pimlet. We'll give you the team as they came out in the first place. Pimlet, Jones, Noonan, Cunningham, Glynn, Francis and William, and the forwards Chisnell, Liptrot, James, Hope, Corelius, Pinner and Flatt and Courtney. But since that has happened, we've got a little bit of sad news for St. Helen. Flatt is on for Pimlet and Courtney's on for Jones, who's got a shoulder injury. Well, that is St. Helens, who have won this trophy twice and get into this final. They beat Dewsbury 51-0. Second round, Lee 14-7. and in the semi-final Salford 7-4. Well, these are the local heroes, of course, with a great lot of talent, led by the mighty mouse Roger Millward, and their team, Hall fullback Dan Smith, Watson Sullivan, halves Hartley Millward, forwards Millington Watkinson, Cunningham, Lowe, Rose and Casey, with Agar and Hughes still untouched. And we've got the way to this final in the first round against Wigan 18-7, second round at Wakefield 14-22, semi-final Castleford 23-5, and the trophy that thereafter is there with Mr. Alan Hart, head of sport with BBC TV, will be giving the trophy to the winner. And the usual plaudits for the referee and two test judges, which are Mr. Norton and Mr. Barrow and Mr. Beaverton. With me, the kickoff's just going to be taken. So David Oxley, who is secretary of the Rugby Football League, and he, how did you read the first half?
Well, fine first half, but increasingly dominated by this rampaging Hulkingston Rovers pack. They're big, five of them are internationals, they run their weight and they support each other superbly. So the St Helens side have got a lot on, they've been tackling manfully, none better than the youngsters Luke Trott and Pinner, and they've enjoyed a fair amount of possession. They've got to use the distributive skills of Bill Francis if they're going to get back into this game, but we know the Saints, they never give up, and there's plenty to play for now.
And a penalty for St Helens in this first of the second half. In the first half, penalties were 5 to St Helens, 4 to LKR, and scrums, St Helens 7, LKR 4. And Bill Francis, who's got a job and a half on his hands now without Pimlet and without Jones. So the dark blue shirts, unusual colours for Hulkingston Rovers on the right against the red and white of St Helens. Chisnall. The more impressive start for St Helens, Corelius giving a hard pass to Cunningham. Not seen a lot of Cunningham in this match so far, but there's nearly 40 minutes to go. Going to have a drop. Oh, what a pathetic effort, actually, by Bill Francis. Chasing 11 points to 3. St Helens leading at half-time. Obviously, a big handicap to lose their captain, Pimlet. Jeff Pimlet, quite a good leader, a good director, and great cheers from this very, very big crowd for Pimlet, looking very worried about it at the moment, because it's doubtful whether, and Les Jones, they're looking very unhappy with the situation, and understandably so. And George Nichols, three great plays there. Well, a very big and vociferous crowd, because Hulkingston Rovers have never won this trophy. In fact, the local paper says it's begun a chance for Sullivan, chance for Clive Sullivan, but it's not coming off. But I was interrupted on the edition of that local paper here that for 52 years since they beat Lancashire opponents in a cup tie.
An example there of this magnificent forward play by the Hulkingston Rovers pack didn't quite come off, the last pass going down, but the St Helens have got to get up and meet them. They're standing back on their heels, and this is fatal against a pack of this dimensions and ability.
This is the 13th Fledley final, previous 12 finals, 6 to Yorkshire and 6 have gone to Lancashire, and for the division situation, OKR are fifth and St Helens are third. But a nice chance on for Sullivan with the forward pass. He can go dashing on, but he'll have to walk back, because Millward pass to Sullivan was offside, and is he saying something? I think he is, actually. Well, the referee was there on the right, saw him very quickly. Guy Sullivan, one of the greats in rugby league football, near the end of his career, but not with this sort of football. Roger Millward having a word, and somebody talking. But when they talk and talk out of turn or query a decision, then they lose 10 yards, and I think that was against Roger Millward for chatting. Certain amount of tension now creeping into the game. Graham Liptroft looking for a football. The popular side, Craven Park, has got a football to play with tomorrow. Three tries to help Kingston Rovers so far against one to St Helens. 5 minutes into the second half, and a knock on, and Tony Corrales not feeling, of course, very happy about that thing. He's playing loose forward at the moment. Neil Courtney's gone into the second row, and the absence of the three players you saw in the bench is a very worrying one for St Helens. A big job on hand for them now to save this match, but they're putting all they've got into it. And Casey of LKR. Millwall going on the opening, really belting. He saw the opening with his eagle eye, and he went with his little flirted dart through the middle. Just a little too long for him. Coming up from the second row position, Paul Rose. Moving it out along the line, Millington. Big John Millington. All the ingredients of a cup tie to fit in a final of this BBC Two floodlit trophy. Only missed one game in four game hole, but that's some tremendous matches, and it's advantage anyway. I think it hit his knee, actually. Ken Gwilym. Eddie Cunningham. Mel James. France have been a good buy, and Harry Pinner. But this boy Pinner is going to, he is a good footballer, he's going to make a top class one. Graham Liptroft. St Helens forward pass. St Helens need a try here, and it looks to me as if ball possession now going to be so important. Another St Helens being spoken to.
Bill Francis almost working his man through there. He's the pivot around which the St Helens are building some quite bright football, but in the first half the handling let them down rather. It's a little bit greasy, not too bad, and rather uncharacteristic handling mistakes plus St Steer in the first half.
St Helens are taking the scrums, 8-5, which is important. See what they do with Millward putting the ball in, because there's always an advantage from the side that's putting the ball in. Not in. Millward again to feed the scrum, and feet up. But somebody put the feet up early in the scrum. And the referee was going to penalise them for not getting 10 yards back. But they went back with him, so he's not penalising. Goes forward, Len Casey. Unusual to see Al Kingston Rovers in blue. Probably said it before, but it doesn't matter. I can say it again. Blue against the whites of St Helens. And a big pillow, real big strong runner. Played well in Australia on the hard ground, but now settled back in England. A dummy not working, and Paul Rose went rolling round without the ball near him, but with him attacking, just a bit of needle coming in, but don't forget it is a trophy final. Players being pushed back, and the referee going in to see what is happening. Billy Platt is the man concerned, and Ken Henthorne on to
attend to Billy Platt. Let's see if it's troubling him. Well, they're giving the referee the benefit of their advice and what he should do, or somebody. And I should imagine that to get the St. Helens player onto the job from David Oxley. Do you want to tip anybody at this moment?
Well, the tip must be Hull KR at the moment. Saints needed an early score. They haven't managed it yet. And Rovers Pack are still dominating up front. It's hard to see how Saints are going to break it down at the moment.
Well, the score is 11-3 to break down, and its ball possession could be vital. And the crowd yelled forward. Ten minutes down in the second half of this 13th BBC Two floodlit final. I would imagine if St. Helens did get a try here, there would be a different pattern then taking place on this ground with both sides. Up and under, it's an awkward one. Sullivan's there collecting it well and running away from trouble. And for position, running away brilliantly. What a good run, a saving take. Short of the halfway line.
Great favourite for this Humberside crowd, of course, Clive, and delighted with his selection yesterday for the Welsh team to meet France in January.
David Watkinson, hooker for Hull KR. There's chance of an eye stand inside Mike Smith, but he's going effectively pushing the ball forward to Dave Hall, and David Hall giving it to a very good try indeed to Steve Hartley, and a very delighted Millward, and a very good supporting play that came from the Sullivan clearance of an up and under and then went away and ended in this try to make Hull KR 14, St. Helens 3.
A wonderful piece of play by this under 24 centre Mike Smith. Old heads on a young shoulders here. He keeps his head, looks inside for the support, which is there from David Hall, and then it's just a matter of David sending Steve Hartley in. But wonderful play by this young under 24 centre, who will be going to France this weekend for the return match against the French under 24 team at Tonnens.
Four tries to Hull Kingston Rovers. One to St. Helens, who are not having any luck, but at the same time, there was a lot of brilliance about that try, with Sullivan really setting up the seat and the encouragement of the start, taking an awkward up and under, and then moving away 27, 28 yards, and from then it was on. And the kicker, Dave Hall, it's up. It was very close, but it was up to make the score 16-3 for Hull Kingston Rovers. Now that might be the killer problem, because Eric Ashton, obviously not very pleased about that, but very phlegmatic, not showing his feelings. But Hull Kingston Rovers, with 12 minutes in, leading 16-3, and as they would say in soccer, they being in this case St. Helens. And then Les Jones, who incidentally was given the yellow card for an alleged tripping offence. But this try you've just seen will have put a lot of pressing power into the Robin, the local name for Hull Kingston Rovers. Just to play Graydon Street, produced many great players. This was a Castleford production, and that is a Welshman, and he's really back in form. Is Clive Sullivan, he really looks as if he's enjoying his rugby league. Ah, he's somewhere or another. to one in indicating the superiority of this stage of the home team. Never won this trophy, leading the scrum, Ken Gwilym. And away they go. Not an impossible task by any means for St. Helen, but they need the encouragement of a quick try. Bill Francis is directing from the middle with the captain Pimlet out of the game. Aurelius to Hope. 25-yard line. Try here, and this is the sort of player who could do it, Mike Finner, but not with big 6'3" Phil Lowe hanging around his neck. Nice. Six tackle coming up. Finner up and under on the sixth one, so it's not a bad shot. It depends how it bounces, but it ran away. It needed to bounce back to get the spin of the thing and follow it up. Quarter of an hour gone. St. Helens, the big win in 75-76, 22-2. At the moment is 16-3. See whether that's going to be beaten. But of course, in reverse order, as we say, with the Beauty Queens. Some good attacking football coming up from the strong Rovers Park, playing at home, got a very big crowd, the best crowd for a long while. Certainly a good crowd for a floodlit match. Ah, good football. Putting the ball around, and encouraged by this lead, pressed on by Millward. Six tackles coming up. Sullivan. Here I go wandering. Sullivan, he goes all over the place. Task too big for St. Helens.
It certainly looks it at the moment, Eddie. One noticed just there that when Bill Francis tried to put Eddie Cunningham through, a great fine runner that he is, it was Mike Smith back again making a tremendous tackle. This Hulkington Rovers side, from time to time, have been a bit suspect in defence, but as they showed us in the semi-final at Castleford, they're just as hard in defence nowadays as they are when this pack is on the rampage and going forward. Very hard to see how St. Helens are going to get back into this. The heads are not down, they're trying all the time. Liptrop still giving them a fair share of possession, but they've got a long, long way to go.
St. Helens getting the ball 9-5. And Hulkington Rovers have swapped their props round. Millington and Cunningham swapping round. Obviously done to try and get better possession, which is almost a 2-1 advantage. And St. Helens certainly need the ball from the scrums. And one keeps looking, where is the breaks going to come? Because in addition to the two players who started the match not playing, Matthias, of course, is not playing, but it's 17 minutes into the second half in this floodlit final. Then Casey. 15, Neil Courtney. John Millington. About 10 yards, 11 yards out. Knock on, advantage, and allowed advantage, six tackles, John Cunningham. There are chance now, there was Sullivan staying on his wing. The experienced, crafty Sullivan, he didn't go in, he wasn't drawn in, he stayed with his partner to stop him making any break. A long one, he's got a bounce right, doesn't, but it comes off. That's not a good pass, but it's well taken by Billy Platt. Referee looking across at John Millington. He had a little few words to say to him in the first half, and now I'm in another little chat. Well, let's have a look at the incident. Number 8 is the man concerned, and Harry Pinner was the man on the receiving end. Position made. And St. Helens running down the middle. Neil Courtney getting out of one, coming back in the other. 16 points to 3. Hulkington Rovers 16. 19 minutes in, which means there's 21 minutes to go. One or two running up. Gonna go on his own, Gwen William. And we've got Peter Glynn coming up as the dummy half. Try here will give St. Helens a lot of encouragement. They're rather a risky thing to do, but it, I wouldn't say it's come off, but at least it hasn't gone too far away. Francis with a bit of the Lewis Jones dock kick run. Billy Platt. So Eddie Cunningham are not getting through with that one. And they score 16 points to 3 at the halfway through the second half in this Bledley final. 16 points to 3. 4 tries to Hull KR, 1 to Hull Kingston Rovers. And Roger the Dodger finding a way through, looking for support, Steve Hartley. Hull Kingston Rovers fans applauding that break. Okay, obviously very confident at the moment with the touch judge in, speaking to Ken William and Jed Dunn. The Beavers of Halifax, the man reporting it.
The Saints handling letting them down twice there are in promising positions. It must be remembered that this whole Kingston Rovers tackling is tremendous. You remember in the semi-final, Castleford appeared to drop the ball a lot in that second half when they were attacking strongly. But this whole Kingston Rovers side really have steeled their tackling over the last 5 or 6 weeks.
Defending and then making attacking sorties and obviously playing with great confidence and using the big powerhouse men, in that case John Cunningham, dummy half Len Casey. A break there for Mike Smith, being supported by Millward, sandwiched between two. Oh, he gets a lovely pass out and away. Beautiful football. Beautiful football. Mike Smith had followed round to quite a few players. Millward was in at it, making it that it being the score. 19 points to 3 and a delighted crowd. And the fifth try.
Let's pick out again this brilliant player by this young centre, Mike Smith. Won his beautiful support run, exactly the right position now. And again, keeping his head as he takes the tackle, and of course, Roger the Dodger's there. And again, Roger the Dodger shows just how it should be done. Two men out, and the ball away to Dunn, and a magnificent try for Hull KR to put them really now in what must be a definite winning position, I feel.
Well, Mike Smith's first try of the season in a reasonable position. 2 goals kicked by Hall. Crowd says it's in, and the test judges confirm it to make the score 21 points to 3. And St. Helens obviously now in trouble, but one cannot emphasize too strongly the loss of Jet Fimlet, the leading point scorer in the rugby league before today's match. 6 tries, 71 goals, 2 drop goals, and also Les Jones with 9 tries. They went out of action in the first half. Fimlet very, very soon, and a big blow to them, of course. Penalty against St. Helens.
21 points to 3, and the previous in 75-76, St. Helens 22, at Dewsbury 2, and then Millward, who played for Castleford in 65-66, when Castleford beat St. Helens 4-0. But I would think this will be his greatest triumph so far as, or one of his great triumphs as far as club football is concerned. Of course, he's got a lot on the international scene. And he's really masterminded this impressive, robust Robbins. Standing deep, Millward. Oh, beautiful pass to Steve Hartley. Anybody going to chase him? Turning it back inside. Beautifully taken by Jed Dan. What a glorious, glorious try in rugby league. And the crowd arise to that. It had got everything. Skill, speed, support in play. And it says a lot for the guts of St. Helens to try to stand up to the might of that try, which makes it 24 points to 3. And Millward doesn't have to drive his players on. He knows full well they're going on.
Well, the genius of this little master, Roger Millward. He takes the men out, round the men to Steve Hartley's supporting run. A great finisher, Steve Hartley, and all credit to Saints, because they do get across to stop him. But Jed Dunn's there to take the inside pass, and there's certainly no stopping him.
24 points to 3. 6 tries to 1. And Hall with a 6 goal shot. 50% success so far, King 3. David Hall. An easy one. Should get 2 points. The flags are up. Making it 26 points to 3. And Roger Millward, who we've done all the superlatives we can, and he's having a little bit of strong talking, but he doesn't really get himself excited. He was going to be a soccer player, but he turned out Castleford had two great halfbacks in Hepworth and Hardesty. There was no room for him at that time. He then turned out to be possibly one of the great standoffs for a long, long time. 26 points to 3. And 26 minutes gone, 14 to go. And there's still life. St. Helens are standing up to this in the best way they can, but they've had to switch their positioning about, and of course the loss of their leader is very evident. Let's play on. Well, I might have queried Mr. Morton on that, but it would have made no difference had I done so. But Rovers are in full swing and full blow, and they're relishing this situation, and it's a record final score on BBC Two Bledley Trophy, which has had some very good season. In fact, rugby league attendances generally are up quite a lot this season. Well, they're already chanting in soccer style fashion, "We won the cup." Actually, it isn't a cup, it's a trophy, but St. Helens. Harry Pinner. Just one try to Peter Glynn so far, and a penalty for obstruction on Ken William. They'll be going for a try from this position, so near the post. The opening's there, is it? Looking for inside support, good at the pass. Billy Platt, the referee bringing them back. That is making them get the required number of yards. Well, St. Helens deserves some solace try, if nothing else might help. Points to 3. The 3 to the team in possession. St. Helens. A long one. And still going with 11 minutes to go. Sticking in that position, but getting nothing much to show for it. Must be in, must be in. He is in. Peter Glynn in for a consolation try, their second, to make it Hulkingston Rovers 26, St Helens 6. And there's the scorer, Peter Glynn, his 11th try of the season. And a consolation try, certainly for Peter Glynn, who'll take the goal kick.
Peter Glynn's second try there, where Hulkingston was awfully concerned about it. A nice piece of play made by Bill Francis, who's been trying to orchestrate this Saints attack all evening. And a slip there in the tackle allows Peter Glynn to go over.
They're not even going to let him kick the goal easily. They're going to get their money's worth, and they're getting it tonight with a score of 26 points to 6. And the little lads and the little robins will be a great Christmas treat for them, that at least they won this trophy with 10 minutes to go, unless some remarkable miracle happens. Millwater kick. Millward, of course, played in both half-back positions. In fact, I've seen him play on the wing in international football. He seems to enjoy his football wherever he plays it. He's not right bothered, as they say. Well, I told you a few minutes ago that Hulkingston had switched their props, and it's rather significant in doing so. They've got their last three scrums, but they didn't get that one. Dummy pass, advantage, Mike Smith, football of the two to this boy, already had honours, big burly John Cunningham, 25 yard line, reverse in position, and there the little master will spread his rubber little darts around. And somebody's in to protect him, but they had one or two players there. Tony Corelli is looking as chance, and so is Dave Chisnall, and it was Mr. Barrow of Pontefract, and Tony Corelli says, name, not me. Quite a likable though, Corelli, the family, of course, of the Corelli footballers, well known in various spheres.
Grand character Tony, no one's tried harder than him in the unaccustomed role of second row forward. Saints, of course, without their two international second row forwards, Eric Chisnall and George Nichols, and this is a great loss, of course, in addition to poor Jeff Pimlet being off so early in the game.
And the rather interesting point about this goal kick is that it's the first penalty shot at goal. It's by David Fall, and he's kicked that towards the docks, but it's not reached there, and it's not gone through the post. So the score stays 26 points to 6 with the home team, Hull KR. And some minutes to go before the final glories and meet with all the fans here at Craven Park. Being very sporty, even though their own team won't score enough points for them. 26-6 is something to be talked around Hull up till Christmas. Turning the man out, left the ball, it must be offside if he got it, but he didn't get it, fortunately.
Humberside, a real hotbed of the game, of course, Eddie, at schools and amateur level, as well as the professional level, and this win, which we now feel is coming, will be absolutely delighting all the fans here and those watching in the city and ground.
Yeah, before the match, I met some of the Penner star footballers in the local league, which are very strong, and
St Helens now coming under the lash of Mr Norton, but it's going to be a scrum down. And Penners are promoting the man of the match. I don't know who it is. Just a little bit of aggro, but after the tenseness, Chisnall and Cunningham matching up, and obviously talking, and Roger Millward tackling somebody before he played the ball. Ken Williams trying to get the kick in. It was a delayed pass. It's a knock-on. He can run as far as he wants. He's got to come back. Bernard Watson. It was so obviously a knock-on, but of course, rugby league footballers don't only wait for the first whistle. They want to make sure and wait for the second. 5 minutes to go. There's the score. Hull Kingston Rovers 26, St Helens 6. And it's been a final with a lot of interest, merit, skill about it. Never got out of hand. Mick Norton, who has never refereed a Fledley final, simply because they've been in Lancashire for half a dozen times. Dave Chisnall injured, and Ken Henthorne on. Very good crowd here tonight, would you? You know, Craven Park.
An excellent crowd, and very indicative of, as I said earlier, this tremendous support for the league on Humberside, and they'll be absolutely delighted with this win.
What about the numbers? How many do you reckon?
I think about 8,000, maybe. Just an eye estimate. 8,000 at least, I would think.
6-2. It's a record final score. St Helens and in possession, and have kept in the game as much as they could, with great disadvantage losing Finland early on. But 4 minutes to go, plus injury time, and they're still trying to the end. They're not drawing the sponge in at all on St Helens. Pass in, a nice one, should be something. There's the try line, there's the 25-yard line. Sort of a half dummy by Dave Chisnall. Francis. It's so near, but it's not near enough with one tackle to go. Mull James. Here because the ball gone into touch with Neil Courtney having it along. 3 minutes plus injury time already. The Utah's not gone, but the youngsters are on the field. They'll have to go off. They'll be very foolish to come on now. It would spoil a great moment and give them the due running off as fast as they can. And the referee, Mick Norton, asked before the match, and it was given out that if they ran on to the field, that there'd be trouble and it would abandon the match. And he's a strong referee.
Somebody has to go.
Number 12, please.
Crowd has just said it officially. 10,099. So please with that,
delighted,
Mr. Secretary.
Delighted to do that wrong. I think it's the Fledley record myself, isn't it?
Just a little bit of the needle creeping in now. Not helped by people running on the field. The tension can easily slap with that sort of thing. John Cunningham. Chance for St Helens.
Hi, Mum.
He's in, must be in for a try. Eddie Cunningham, and persistency has been rewarded with a try to Eddie Cunningham and a chance to go into double figures, which looks a lot more respectable than 9 at 11. 26 points to 9 at the moment. And Low Hancock.
Eddie fixing himself over there. And normally he scores his try from a longer range. He's a fine runner. But a determined try by Eddie there. Just purely academic now, of course, at this stage of the game.
Peter Glenn to kick. 26 points to 9. And kick to go. 3 tries for the Saints. And in a goal. So into double figures. And certainly looks a much more respectable score. With time really running out. Forty minutes gone. Full injury time now. And making a switch. Put it bringing on a sub. Mike Hughes for John Cunningham. And number 10, John Cunningham, didn't know, but he goes out, and on comes his replacement. What is certain is the cup is going to be presented to Roger Millward by Alan Hard, head of sport of BBC TV, along with Sitter from the Rugby League, Mr. Eddie Bottomley, Assistant Secretary of the Rugby Football League, and Mr. John Eccleston of BBC Manchester, and Mr. Ronnie Simpson, the former chairman of the Rugby Football League. They will be doing the honours at the end of the match.
Woo! This is Bill Bratton.
This is heavy pay!
Somebody... Obstruction. Obstruction. And just at the end of the match, a little bit of feeling creeping in. Not too serious. The cup tie. Attention. A lot of tension being evident. And they will no doubt find all good friends together after when they mix. Bill Francis. And the forward pass, and scrum down.
Kevin Bay speaking.
And there goes the hooter. So a new name goes on for the T2. Bledelit stroking that of Hull Kingston Rovers, bringing them for the first time this trophy to Humberside, having beaten Wigan and Casper, both previous winners, and Wigan and now and Wakefield and now St. Helens. So the presentation is going to be made, and the support indicated the following of four Hull Kingston Rovers. St. Helens handicapped by the loss of Pimblett in the early stages, and then Jones off, but a lot of good friendship after 26 points to 11 to Hull Kingston Rovers. And Roger Millward, the hero of the hour, or an hour and 20 minutes, receiving the trophy from Mr. Alan Hart, who used to produce rugby league football before his rise in BBC television, and there's the BBC Dudley Trophy. Main stand side at Craven Park, David Hall, Millington, Jed Dunn, Bernard Watson had triumphs before, but no doubt this is Craven at the moment. Paul Rosen passing it on to John Cunningham. Steve Hartley's tried a lot to do with Clive Silver, and he'll be enjoying himself tonight. Len Casey And a toothless middle not knocked out today. I can assure you, Phil Lowe. He'll have those in before the night's out. David Watkinson. Two from Craven Park with